Ladies and gentlemen, dear Commissioner Canete, it's a great pleasure for me to welcome you in this beautiful city of Chania in Crete for the inaugural forum for an initiative that the European Commission and 14 member states we decided last May in Valletta. The symbolism of this first ever clear energy for EU Islands Forum, taking place in the largest island of a maritime nation whose many islands and islets in the Aegean compose the southeastern border of the European Union, underlines the commitment of Europe to accelerate the transition to clean energy on islands. And apart from that, this European initiative is launched in a country whose government is determined to implement swiftly and fully the Paris Climate Agreement and take an active role in the global transition to clean energy. We brought protection of the environment and climate from the sidelines of the political agenda to the center of the quest on how our society can move on to the future. And we made long-term energy planning a political priority. And that, despite the seven-year economic and social crisis from which we are now exiting. Because as inequalities in clean energy access find reflection in social inequalities, for us, affordable clean energy for everyone is more empowering remote islands with the necessary means to rid themselves of their reliance on diesel and move to renewable energy. It is even more than helping families reduce high energy bills or developing local jobs and local economies. For us, it is an instrument for social justice and change. This is why it is an uncompromising political priority. Greece has already taken an active role in environmental protection in Europe. We should not forget that we are the only lignite-producing country in the European Union which has been pushing for the adoption of stricter limits or emissions. But our efforts and contribution to clean energy transition are multifaceted. Domestically, the share of renewables in the energy mix is steadily increasing, and the achievement of European targets in 2020 can be taken for granted. In addition, we have adopted the guaranteed price system and the first competitive process for photovoltaic plants, where completing the consultation with the European Commission on a plan for competitive bidding for all forms of renewable energy sources, photovoltaics, wind power, or if there is interest, biomass and small hydroelectric plants. At the same time, we are promoting a modern spatial plan for renewable energy sources the existence of which will help avoid time-consuming legal implications. In close cooperation with the Commission, we are also moving forward with the modernization of the environmental licensing framework for renewable energy sources. The promotion of electromobility is also a central issue to be brought forward in the next period. Ladies and gentlemen, Greece has 32 isolated electric systems of various sizes. Existing systems are mainly based on diesel combustion units. So in the area of decarbonization of islands, there is particular interest both in terms of interconnections as well as in terms of transition to low carbon systems. Smart islands with high penetration of renewables and reduction of energy costs is our vision and at the same time is our ambition. We are committed to this end, implementing and testing innovative projects in Greek islands, an effort that will accelerate. In addition, some days ago, the Ministry of Energy announced a very significant organized long-term energy planning procedure, which is crucial for energy transition. It immediately initiates a specific timetable for integration, taking into account current trends and commitments to environmental and energy issues, the international energy system, the goal of a European integrated market, and the availability of energy resources. The aim is security of supply, consumer protection, and the welfare of the country in general. Through this process, binding targets will be set in the context of our country's European international obligations, such as the Paris Climate Agreement and EU targets for 2030. In particular, actions and policies will be specified to ensure the success of this process. It concerns five dimensions of the energy union: energy security, energy market, energy efficiency, exceptions from carbon emissions, research, innovation, and competitiveness. The Greek government has already submitted to the Parliament a new legislative framework for the local energy communities. Greece is the first among the EU countries to legislate this based on the recast of the two European directives. The local energy communities present opportunities for synergies between citizens, between small and medium enterprises, local and regional authorities and institutions. The framework has been designed to allow for decentralized and efficient energy transition, pointing into the direction of innovative energy production, which is based on local ownership and initiatives. The element of locality is central to their design, as the basic aim of the proposed law is to generate added value for local communities as well as to alleviate energy poverty. The draft law takes account of the country's particular morphology, that is its intense insularity. The concept of insularity refers to isolation and removal from the center. We accordingly introduce specific provisions for energy communities on islands with a small population that is of less than 3,100 people. In addition, the initiative creates a favorable framework for the development of renewable energy sources, power plants from local societies, enabling local communities to engage in the promotion of clean energy. Dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, Greece takes on responsibilities and initiatives. And this is, let me say, a historic opportunity and responsibility towards the next generations. A responsibility that we should take, as we discussed before with Commissioner Caneta, we should take. We should not allow future generation to blame us for not seizing it. We are here not only to discuss, we are here to take decisions, we are here to take steps, brave steps, and we should take them. So I wish every success in this forum. The momentum, I believe, is correct. And I want to assure you that the Greek government strongly supports this initiative, and we expect that it will give the right signal, the correct signal for the next day. Thank you very much, and I hope big success in this conference.